go to break, we want to remember a local news colleague. WGHP is reporting that their longtime sportscaster, Rich Brenner, died of a heart attack last night. Rich was a fixture on local TV for over two decades and was very well known in our community. And we were privileged enough to have him on our air as a guest in recent years. Rich is survived by his wife, two kids, and two grandchildren. Our Cameron Kent knew him well, and here's how he's remembering Rich this morning.
Sad news about our good friend Rich Brenner. I have known Rich for 30 years. Met him in 1982 when he was the sports director at WTVD in Durham. I was the sports director here at WXII. We sat next to each other at a lot of football games, a lot of basketball games. The man absolutely loves sports, particularly the ACC and NASCAR. I have three very vivid recollections of my time spent with Rich. The first one was 1984. I'll never forget it. We were staying in a tower in the infield at Daytona. It was the Bush Clash, and Ricky Rudd's Wrangler car coming around turn four and does an awful barrel roll. And I just remember Rich reaching up to his head and going, "Ricky, Ricky, Ricky." And unfortunately, Ricky survived that crash, but I'll never forget that moment standing there with Rich. A few years later, Rich got on a health kick, and he'd lost a lot of weight. And I was overweight at the time, and he inspired me. He called me up, he said, "You need to do this." And so I went out and lost about 40 pounds. And I remember calling up saying, "Thank you. You know, it was because of you and you pushing me along to do that, that I made that change in my life, and I will always appreciate that." But my fondest memory, and I think this speaks to the man more than anything, I was at Rich's induction into the Silver Circle for the National Academy of Television Arts and Sciences in Nashville a few years ago. That's 25 years of broadcasting and accomplishments in our region. And Rich got up there for his acceptance speech, and he didn't talk about all the things that he'd accomplished, which were significant. He talked about all the people who helped him accomplish those things and how important they were in his life, the people he had worked for, the people he had worked with, and particularly his family, especially his wife. I'll always remember him breaking down in tears and saying, "She's my moral compass, and behind every good man is a good woman," and that's how Rich Brenner felt. He was very well liked, very well respected. Our profession has lost a good man. The world has lost a great man in Rich Brenner.
Rich Brenner was 65 years old.